In this video, you'll find out how to import a website layout from Figma to Tilda automatically. To import the layout correctly, you need to follow some criteria for the layout. The Figma frame's width should be 1200 pixels. Note that I have a layout of 1920 pixels, so I've created two frames beside it where I've copied and centered the content of two blocks. In this step, you won't have any difficulties, as if you designed for Tilda, the grid in Figma is the same, 12 columns. It's also better to fit the content into 1160 pixels to include safe paddings. It's better to design each conceptual block in a separate frame to import each frame into a different zero block. To import a button, group the shape, background, and text and name it Button. Note that the shape width and the text container width should be the same. You can also import any group as an image by naming it Image or SVG. I'll transfer this group of dots as an SVG file, and now I'll import the Figma layout automatically. I'll switch to Tilda. Before doing it, I've connected the fonts I use in the layout to the project on Tilda. I'll use Tilda Sans typeface. Let me create a new zero block on the page. Go to the block editor and delete the content I won't use. The block is ready for import. Now you need to get a token. The token is a personal access key to your Figma account. You have to get it just once, and you'll be able to copy it just once as well. If you close the window, you won't be able to access the token again. But of course, you can generate a new one. To get a token, I'll go to Figma, click on the icon in the left top corner, and go to the Help and Account tab. I'll click on the Account Settings, and we'll be able to get a key in the Personal Access Token section. Let me specify its title. I'll name it Tilda. Click Enter, and Figma will generate the key. To copy it, you need to click on Copy this token. Now, let me go back to Tilda, click on the three dots in the right top corner, and select the Import option. I need to paste the copied key to the API token field. I'll go back to Figma again, close the pop-up where I've copied the token, select the frame I need to import, and then I need to copy its URL in the browser address bar. I'm working in the browser version of Figma, and if you are going to work in the app, you won't have an address bar. You can then copy the link to the frame by clicking the Share button and Copy Link. Now, let me go back to Tilda. Paste the copied link to the layout URL field and click Import. And so my layout is on Tilda. Now I can adjust the layout a little bit if necessary. Note that the button has been imported correctly as a button, and I can configure all the settings of the element. It's important to note that images are not uploaded to Tilda by default. If you've checked the layout and you're happy with everything, select the image, click Upload to Tilda, and then your image will be uploaded. Now, all you have to do is to adapt the block visibility for all the devices you need. Let me repeat all the steps once again in another block. I'll create a zero block. Click Block Editor, delete the content I won't use, switch to Figma, select the second frame, copy the link, switch back to Tilda, click on the three dots, import option, and paste the link to the layout URL field. Note that the token is saved, and you don't need to copy and paste it again. And so my second block is on Tilda. By using automatic import, you can speed up your work and save time for other tasks. Thanks for watching this tutorial and for using Tilda. Good luck with creating stunning websites. Bye-bye.